Lord, make me an instrument
of thy purpose.
Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, forgiveness. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair,
hope.
Where there is darkness,
light.
Where there is sadness, joy.
Joy.
O Divine Master,
grant that
I may not so much seek to be consoled,
as to console,
to be understood,
as to understand,
to be loved,
as to love.
For it is in giving
that we receive.
It is in forgiveness
that we are forgiven.
Good morning. Today's National Israelite Honor. India is seriously concerned as Israel-Iran tensions escalate. Ayodhya gears up for Ramlala's first runaway inside Grand Temple. Congress sending black money from Karnataka to other states to fight polls, said PM Modi. External Affairs Minister Jai Shankar speak to Iranian FM on release of 17 Indians on board seized vessel. Air India temporarily suspends Tel Aviv flights amid rising tensions in West Asia.
Good morning. Today's sports news headlines are as follows. In IPL, Pakistan overshadows Rohit's centuries as CSK beat MI by 20 runs. Manchester United vs Bournemouth, Fernandez double salvages draw for United. IPL commentators told to stop posting pictures or videos from the stadium for match detail. Thank you. Only the timid and the weak leave the things to destiny.
But the strong and the self-confident never rely on destiny alone.
Good morning. Today I, Ramani,
and I, Manisha, welcome you to the pleasant morning assembly of 15th April. First of all, we wish you a very contented and prosperous Ram Navami. Ram Navami, this day is marked by the Hindu epic Ramayana, which narrates the tale of Shri Ram. Hindus celebrate this festival by visiting temples, praying, fasting, listening and singing bhajans and kirtans.
The holy Ramcharitmanas and the epics of Ramayana speaks of the true identity of individuals. It teaches us the real significance of family, the sanctity of the society and human value. Janani Janma Bhumischa Svargadapi Gariyasi.
Mother and motherland are greater than heaven. After returning from Lanka, Shri Ram says to Shri Lakshman as they approach Ayodhya, Durlabham hi sada sukham.
To be happy always is something which is very difficult to achieve. That is to say, happiness and sorrow alternate in one's life and there can never be uninterrupted happiness alone.
To learn and take up the lessons from the holy Ramcharitmanas and Ramayana is true devotion to God. And to showcase our devotion to God, I would like to invite our friends Ishita and Ayush on the stage.
Our first thing is, I am here to tell some of the life lessons of Lord Ram. Lesson number 1. Accept life challenges. Just a day before his coronation, his father King Dashrath ordered Shri Ram to leave for 14 years of exile at his second wife Queen Kaki's demand. Born with a silver spoon, he is left with nothing but to live the life of a hermit for more than a decade. Even this life-changing event is not able to shake Lord Ram's strong determination, will and mainly his ability to love and trust others. With hope in his heart and a calm mind, he accepts life as it is and sets on his new journey. Life will not be the same, but he knows he will be able to conquer it all. Lesson number 2. Make the best use of what you have. Ram's war with the demon king Ravan, a conqueror who had the strongest army at the time. On the contrary, Lord Ram had only the support of his Vanar Sena, or an army consisting of monkeys, and yet he emerged victorious. Lord Ram's greatness lies in his ability to see the best in people and optimize his resources to the fullest. He didn't choose defeat, fought with what he had and won. Today, Zenzi can learn a lot from history. Lesson number 3. Stay calm in the face of adversity. The present generation is known for their knee-jerk reactions, impulsive decisions and doing things in heat of the moment. When masculinity is acknowledged with anger, the Maryada Purushottam defined all these laws. Amid the most drastic changes, fighting evil demons or giving up his crown. He was calm, patient and generous. He didn't lose his sense of control and always focused on his own solution. Lesson number 4. Nurture unshakable focus towards your goal. With just his brother by his side, Lord Ram's goal was clear. He had to bring back Ma Sita from the clutches of the evil Ravan. He had no army, no transportation or no clue how he could reach the other side of the sea. Yet he persisted in his goal. We all know the result. He was able to save his beloved wife, we so fondly called Ma Sita. All the other things like meeting Sugriv, Vibhishan and the mighty Hanuman, he figured out all the ways. A major life lesson from this is to focus on your goal, no matter how intimidating it seems, and the sun will shine on you again. Lesson number 5. Never stop learning. Only those who adapt to changing times can survive, especially in the fast-moving world. You will get replaced if you don't involve and embrace constantly. And if you think you are too wise to learn some more, you are mistaken. Even after being the 7th incarnation of Lord Vishnu and born in an affluent household, Lord Ram did everything to learn the skills that could help him move ahead in life. He was a great student, a skillful warrior and an ideal man. His attributes are an inspiration to keep learning in life. Lesson number 6. Don't let power get to your head. People from privileged position are likely to treat people below them with hatred, spite and unkindness. Even those who started from the bottom get influenced by power and forget about the ones and who made them who they are today. Even being the most powerful man in the world, a majestic prime and incarnation of Lord Vishnu, Sri Ram never let power get to his head. He treated everyone equally, from kings to hermits to even animals. A brilliant example is in eating poor old lady Sabri's tasted fruit. He was far away from arrogance and treated everyone with respect. This is what helped him wage a war against the Dashanan with the support of people who stood no chance and yet trembled. Lord Ram was an exemplary human being, and by following his teachings, we can make our life better for ourselves. Thank you and have a nice day.
Facing life's challenges. During his exile, Ram encountered numerous trials. His patience in dealing with these challenges teaches us the art of resilience, showing that we can navigate life's difficulties with grace fortitude. Lesson number 2. Living righteously. Ram serves as a model for following the right path or dharma. Despite significant personal sacrifices, such as 14 years of exile, he chose to honor his father's work, emphasizing the importance of duty and integrity in facing life challenges. Lesson number 3. Love and devotion. Ram's unwavering commitment to his wife Sita demonstrates us the strength of love and dedication. He overcame numerous obstacles to rescue her, teaching us the importance of standing by our loved ones in good times and bad. Lesson number 4. Commitment to learning. Known for his wisdom, Ram valued education and actively sought knowledge. Students can draw inspiration from his dedication to learning, striving to continuously expand their knowledge. Lesson number 5. Emotional mastery. Ram exhibited remarkable control over his emotions. Even in provocative situations, this quality serves as a guide for self-discipline, encouraging us to make balanced decisions and avoid impulsiveness. Lesson number 6. Respect for everyone. Regardless of his royal divine status, Ram treated everyone with respect. His friendship with Hanuman exemplifies humility in leadership, emphasizing that true strength lies in inclusivity. Lesson number 7. Building strong bonds. Throughout his journey, Ram surrounded himself with loyal companions like Lakshman, Hanuman and Sugriv. This underscores the importance of building strong relationships and working together to achieve common goals. Lesson number 8. Kindness and compassion. Despite facing injustice, Ram never sought revenge or harbored hatred. He treated even his enemies with compassion and forgiveness, teaching us the value of seeking peaceful resolutions and maintaining inner peace. Thank you and have a nice day. Facing life's challenges. During his exile, Ram encountered numerous trials. His patience in dealing with these challenges teaches us the art of resilience, showing that we can navigate life's difficulties with grace fortitude. Lesson number 2. Living righteously. Ram serves as a model for following the right path or dharma. Despite significant personal sacrifices, such as 14 years of exile, he chose to honor his father's work, emphasizing the importance of duty and integrity in facing life challenges. Lesson number 3. Love and devotion. Ram's unwavering commitment to his wife Sita demonstrates us the strength of love and dedication. He overcame numerous obstacles to rescue her, teaching us the importance of standing by our loved ones in good times and bad. Lesson number 4. Commitment to learning. Known for his wisdom, Ram valued education and actively sought knowledge. Students can draw inspiration from his dedication to learning, striving to continuously expand their knowledge. Lesson number 5. Emotional mastery. Ram exhibited remarkable control over his emotions. Even in provocative situations, this quality serves as a guide for self-discipline, encouraging us to make balanced decisions and avoid impulsiveness. Lesson number 6. Respect for everyone. Regardless of his royal divine status, Ram treated everyone with respect. His friendship with Hanuman exemplifies humility in leadership, emphasizing that true strength lies in inclusivity. Lesson number 7. Building strong bonds. Throughout his journey, Ram surrounded himself with loyal companions like Lakshman, Hanuman and Sugriv. This underscores the importance of building strong relationships and working together to achieve common goals. Lesson number 8. Kindness and compassion. Despite facing injustice, Ram never sought revenge or harbored hatred. He treated even his enemies with compassion and forgiveness, teaching us the value of seeking peaceful resolutions and maintaining inner peace. Thank you and have a nice day.
Valuable life lessons. Bhajan is important for the devotees because it is intimate and free in expression. Bhajan preserves India's rich legacy of devotion and wisdom. Chanting bhajan gives transcendental peace and provides purification of heart, mind and body. Now we call our friends for a devotional bhajan. Friends, please.
Oh,
When someone is provocating you, how to be obedient, how to be strong, not giving up what is your right, but at the same time also setting examples by following what he presumed the parents wanted him to follow. In senior classes at least, the lessons that were shared here in the assembly, I would like the teachers to share them again when you go to the classes today. You can borrow those lessons from the students who have them with them. So carry them to the classes and share them once again. And I'm sure when the language teachers, either Hindi or English, and other subject teachers also, when you share these things in the class, they become clearer. One thing is little matter of unhappiness. That is, in spite of motivating you all to read, I don't find that you people get involved in reading. The writer of Bal Ramayana, Pankaj Pani Pandeji, he was there with us. At least his presence should have motivated you. There were books called, written by him, Bal Ramayana. Bal Ramayana is not the story of Ramji's childhood. It's a Ramayana which is simplified. Simplified for children to understand, even adults to understand. If you don't have time to read Ramcharitramanas, the original one, at least you could have spent some time reading this Bal Ramayana, which I'm sure if you would read from page 1 to last page, you can read it within 2 hours. So sparing 2 hours at one go is also possible. Sparing 10 minutes every day and doing it in 10 days, 15 days, 20 days was also possible. But why you don't do it, I don't understand. We have called about 40 books kept in the library, you all were informed also. But till date, only 8 students have purchased it. I don't know how many of you have purchased it from Amazon. If you have done that, good. Now also you can get these books from the Amazon and do a read. Go through these books. Subject teachers should have a little bit of follow-up in the classes. When certain things are suggested in the assembly, even you are a source of great knowledge. Don't restrict yourself to just your subject. If you broaden your views, broaden your vision, and look out for these sources of knowledge, I'm sure you will also get enriched, and you will be enriching the students you are going to touch. So I hope, children, you all have filled your Google Forms for the activities. The activity in charges, so I would request to do the needful so that we can start the activities before the summer break begins. Thank you.